We've already looked at how to configure the data template to bring in simple items for the unit batches and sub-batches, but haven't really configured custom journal actions yet. We've also looked at how these edits that we make to the data template affect the journal. Now, we'd like to bring this information that's in the journal into our report. And the way to do that is through the format template. This is the configuration of our report. Let's start by looking at this existing report, and then we're going to start from our report that we made in our previous video and configure the format template from scratch. Here in our format template, I have two sections that I've already created. The first is the batch overview section, and then I've made another one for the units. Let's take a look at the batch overview section, and let's take a look at the report that's created from this. Here I have a series of items that have been inserted into my format template, which create this section of the report. Some of these are text entries, like the words batch information, which you can see right here, shows up in the report. And then I've also included these breaks, and these make line breaks because we're using HTML markup as part of our report. We also have some data items and some time UTCs. And we're going to show how to bring all of these into your report in just a second. Let's take a look at just a couple of them. Under data here, if I double click on it, I have a source. And this is the batch journal /name. And this corresponds to this section of the report. That gets populated from the journal. So if I go to batch journal /name, you can see here that the name of the report is Potion 1A Compliance Report. So if I were to click and drag this over, it actually populates this source with batch journal /name. And when I run the report, it brings that in right here. Another one that I can look at here is, let's take a look at time UTC. That corresponds to this timestamp here. And you can see that it's pulled from our batch journal from this location. Batch journal, generation date, UTC seconds. So if I go to my journal, batch journal, generation date, UTC seconds, this is what I pulled in here. And when I ran the report, it created this timestamp for me. Let's make this section here for our batch information and one section of a unit, which would be this information here in our report that we started earlier. If I go to File, Open, the report that we were previously working on is called Potion 1A Compliance. And here's our data template with the batch, mixing, heater, and unit batch levels, and the H element sub-batch level. Our journal currently is not fully populated because I haven't selected an event frame. So let me go ahead and do that now. Go to View, Test Report, Use Event Frames. I'm already connected to my database. And under my criteria, I'm going to do *-2 hours. And just select an event frame. And now my journal has populated with actual data for that event frame, but the report is still empty. Let's get started on formatting the report. I'm going to try and create a new section first, but these are all grayed out. Now, when you first create a report, it checks it out, and you may have checked it back in unknowingly. If you ever need to make an edit to a report, you need to manually check it out. So go to File, Checkout. And at the bottom here, it's going to say checked out. Now when I right click and say insert section, I'll add a new section. And this is going to be the batch overview section. This is going to include information on the batch level, not the unit batch or sub batch levels. We're going to work on those a little bit later. And then it automatically has an entry. Within the entry, this is where I want to put the information that goes into the report. And first, let me start by including text that says batch information. So I'm going to right click on my entry, say insert text. And that text is going to be batch information. I want to bold this and make it a little bit bigger. And I'll click OK. If I want to update the report, I can go to View Refresh or hit F5. And now it includes that in my report. The next thing I want to do is bring in the name of the report. If I go to Entry, Insert, and this time it's a data item. I need to find that data item because that's what's going to go into my source. So if I go to Journal and go to Name, I'm going to bring that into my source. And this is just the name of this entry in the format template, so it doesn't really matter, but I'm just going to say report name and click OK. So now it says report name here, and under report, if I hit F5 or go to view, refresh, it now includes the name of the report. Now this doesn't quite look the way we want it. We need a line break in between these. And the way to do that is by adding some HTML markup. HTML markup is included when you add text. So I'm going to add another text item. And to add the break, I'm just going to do caret, break, caret. It's going to insert at the end. I want it in between these two, so I'm going to increase it and put it here. Go to view, refresh, and now I have a break. Now I included it here as a separate item instead of batch information, because batch information is actually a slightly larger text. And if I included it there, the line break would be wider than I actually want. Next, let's bring in the generation date. So I'm going to right click, say insert, and I actually want some text before that. And I need a line break after the words potion 1A compliance. So I'm going to put in my line break. I'm going to say generation date, colon, space. Refresh. Show what that looks like. And then I want an entry from my journal, but this time it's a timestamp. And I'm going to right click and say insert UTC time. And this is going to be the generation date. And the source of that information is going to be from the journal under the generation date, UTC seconds. And it's not going to report it in UTC seconds. It's going to report it in the correct time zone. But it's coming in as UTC. I click OK, go to the report, and refresh. There's a few more items I want to bring in. These are the batch ID, the product, and the recipe. So let me do those quickly. They're all very similar. And it looks like I haven't associated this one with an event frame yet. So let's go to View, Test Report, Use Event Frames. And now you can see it pulls in the batch ID. And in the journal, the batch ID is now populated correctly. So let me do this now with the product and the recipe. And now I have the name of my report, the generation date, the batch ID, product, and recipe. The final item that we want for the batch information section is going to be the start time, end time, and duration. And I'd like that into a table. To do that, let me first create a table under entry. And you would normally right-click, insert, and then select table from here. But because of the screen resolution I'm using, I'm actually going to do that from the insert menu and select table. For the number of rows, I'm going to take 2 rows and 3 columns. The first row has three different table items. So the first table item, I'm actually going to add text. I'm going to say insert text. And this is going to say start time. The second data item in the first row, I'm going to say insert text. And this will say end time. For the third column of the first row, I'm going to say insert text. This will say duration. Let me go ahead and refresh my report. And you can't really tell it's a table. So for the table, I tend to double click border and change the border width to 2. And then let's refresh the report. And you can see this is the first row, the first three columns, whereas the second row is currently empty. And we're going to add some data items into there. So for that second row, the first column, let's actually add the start time. And we're going to do that by going to insert, and we're going to add UTC time. This is the start time. And the source of that comes from the journal. So in the batch journal section under start time, let me pull in UTC seconds. And let me do the same thing for the second column of the second row. Insert UTC time. This is the end time. And I'm going, as the source, I'm going to pull in the end time in UTC seconds. And finally, the duration. For the duration, I'm actually going to use the duration string, and this is just strictly the writing that's shown here, and that's going to be a data item. So I'm going to go to insert data. This is going to be the duration, and I'm going to pull that in. Click OK, go to the report, and then refresh. You can see the start time, end time, and duration have shown up. And these are the start and end time of that first parent level event frame. Next, we want to do the same for the unit batch level. And at the unit batch level, we have multiple units to report on. And we're going to end up using something called iterators. And that will be discussed in the next video. However, let me just show you how some of this works if you weren't using an iterator. So we're just going to bring it in for the very first unit. I'll create a new unit section. I'll right click, say insert section, and I'm going to call this unit information. Within this entry, I'm going to add some text that says unit information. Make it bold. And size 24, and I'm going to click OK. For this one unit, since we're not using iterators, I'm only manually going to create the section for the first unit. I want to bring in a few pieces of information. I'm going to make a table with a start, end time, and duration, just like we did for the previous one, for the batch level. But for this particular unit batch, I want to bring in three pieces of information. The first is the name of the event frame. I also want to pull in the associated AF element, or the PI unit name, which was mixing unit 1. And I also want to bring in the procedure. And all three of these are going to be data items. So let me go ahead and make those first. I'm going to insert text, add a line break. And say insert data item. And this is going to be the name of the event frame. And this is at the child event frame level. I'm going to add another line break. Insert another data item, which has the PI unit, or the AF element that's associated with this level. Insert another line break. And then insert one final data item And this is going to be the procedure. If I go to my report and refresh, we will be able to see what that looks like. And then I want to make a similar table to this, start time, end time, and duration. So what I'm going to do here is actually copy the existing table and paste it into this entry down here. And it's going to put it at the top. I'm going to drag it down to the bottom of that entry. And I am going to need to make some edits because right now it doesn't know that I want the start and end time and duration of the unit. But the first row is fine with the words start time, end time, and duration. But these separate items in here, I'm going to need to make some edits. So for start time, this is the one I no longer want. Those were pulled from down here from the batch journal. But instead, I'm going to go into the unit batch journals. And for this first unit batch, I'm going to pull in the start time in UTC seconds. I'm going to do the same for the end time. And then for the duration, I'm going to pull in the duration string. And if I go into my report, I'll refresh. And you can see for the batch information, this batch actually lasts 11 minutes for the total batch time. And then this first unit, it actually only lasts 2 minutes. You can see that this unit starts at the same time as the batch starts. But instead of lasting 11 minutes, it only lasts 2 minutes. Now, since we have multiple units, we wouldn't manually build these out individually. You would actually use something called iterators, which we will discuss in the next video. Then we'll start going into the custom journal actions that we make in the data template to get information about the pH or the heater current into our reports. One final item, sometimes tech support for troubleshooting may want information about your format template. To export all of this information here, we get the XML from you, and we request that you go to File, Export the format template from the editor, and then send that to us for troubleshooting.